We're now going to start looking at CSS properties. The color property, as we've already seen, can set the color of text in one of five different ways. By default, its value is set to inherit, meaning it will inherit the color of its parent element. Text transform controls the casing of text, and text decoration can add one or more decorations, such as underlining text. Just like every other property, it can use the inherit value, so I won't include it here unless it's the default value for the property. Text indent indents the first line of text, and text align aligns text. Both text indent and align can only be used on block level elements, such as headers or paragraphs, while the other three can be applied to all elements. If we look at an example, we can set paragraphs to be uppercased using text transform and then underlined using text decoration. To add several decorations, we can simply separate them with a space. Text indent can be set to any unit of measure or a percentage of the parent element's width. It can also indent text backwards using a negative value. Finally, we can center the text using text align. If we add an inline element, such as EM, and try to center it instead, it won't work since text align only works on block elements.